गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक अगेन। सो लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इक्विलिब्रियम। सो व्हाट इज इक्विलिब्रियम? व्हाट इज रिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन, इरिवर्सिबल रिएक्शन, व्हाट इज लॉ ऑफ मास एक्शन एंड व्हाट इज इक्विलिब्रियम कॉन्स्टेंट। सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अप टू दिस। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट टुडेस पार्ट। सो लास्ट क्लास आई हैव फिनिश्ड इन वन सेंटेंस, दैट इज द इक्विलिब्रियम कॉन्स्टेंट is represented in various ways, that is either Kc or Kp or Kx. Okay, so suppose this equilibrium constant is represented either by Kc or by Kp or by it is represented in terms of Kc, Kp and Kx. So when molar concentration of the reactants and products are considered, then generally the equilibrium constant K is known as Kc. And if the partial pressure of the reactant and products are considered, then this is known as Kp. And when the equilibrium constant is represented in terms of mole fraction of the reactants and products, then the equilibrium constant is known as Kx. Okay, so let us consider a general reversible gaseous reaction, that is A of A plus B of B give rise to C of C and D of D. All are in gaseous form. Okay? So in this way, so what is the equilibrium constant? A is equal to, that is concentration of C to the power C, concentration of D to the power D, concentration of A to the power A, product by reactant. So in this way, concentration of B to the power B. Okay, so actually if we take the molar concentration of this is known as your Kc. So in some cases, when the molar concentration is also represented by another letter, that is C. So this C stands for the concentration. So C to the power C. So here I have written 3 C's. So this C for the concentration term, for this molar concentration term, and this C is known as the reactant, and this C is your coefficient. So 3 C's are there. 1 C for coefficient, small c coefficient, and this is the product, this is the reagent, that is the product, and this is for concentration. So this molar concentration can also represented as C to the power C and C D to the power D divided by C A to the power A and C B to the power B. So when we take the molar concentration, either you can write like this or you can write like this, this is known as Kc. This equilibrium constant is known as Kc. Similarly, Kp. So the reactant, the product is that the partial pressure of C to the power C into partial pressure of D to the power D by partial pressure of A to the power A, partial pressure of B to the power B. Similarly, Kx, this is in terms of mole fraction, that is mole fraction of C. C is the reagent or product. Reagent, the reagent may be reactant or a product. Xc to the power C, Xd to the power D, that is Jc to the power C, Jd to the power D, divided by Ja to the power A, Jb to the power B. So in this way, you can represent Kx. So it looks like X, the symbol, but this is actually Jai, pronounced as Jai. So Kx, Xc to the power C, Xd to the power D, Xa to the power A, Xb. This is known as Kx, or equilibrium constant in terms of mole fraction, equilibrium constant in terms of partial pressure, and equilibrium constant in terms of molar concentration. Okay, so note down this. So equilibrium constant represented in GUH, Kc, Kp, or Kx. So let us consider a general reversible gaseous reaction at equilibrium. So A of A plus B of B give rise to C of C plus D of D. When molar concentration of the reactants and products are considered, the equilibrium constant represented as Kc. So in this we can represent Kc. And when the partial pressure of the reactant and products are considered, in terms of partial pressure, the equilibrium constant is known as Kp. And in terms of mole fraction, the equilibrium constant is known as Kx. So note down this. Next come to what is the interrelationship between different types of equilibrium constants. Okay, so relationship between Kc and Kp. Relationship. So we know, so the general equation A of A, so the equation is A of A plus B of B give rise to C of C plus D of D, all are in gaseous form. Okay, all are in gaseous form. If the reaction is there, then we know what Kc is equal to C to the power C and C D to the power D divided by C A to the power A and C B to the power D. Suppose this is equation 1. And we know what is Kp? Kp is equal to P C to the power C and P partial pressure of D to the power D, partial pressure of A to the power A, partial pressure of B to the power B. Okay? Again, this equation actually holds good if this is ideal gas, if this all over this ideal gas equation. And for ideal gas equation, for ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT or P is equal to nRT by V. So this N by V that gave rise to the concentration term that is known as your C, that is equal to CRT. So P is equal to CRT for any component. See the total pressure, total concentration, and if any component PIV is also NIRT, or we can say PI is equal to NIRT by V. In the content of total volume is V, so PI NIRT by V, this N by RT, or this implies that, and again, this implies that PI is equal to CIRT. The height component is there. Similarly, four components are there, A, B, C, D are there. So in this way, this is equation 2, this is equation 2, and this is equation 1. Similarly, what is the partial pressure of A? We can write that is CARP. Similarly, partial pressure of B, we can write CBRP. Partial pressure of C, CCRP. And partial pressure of D, that is CDRP. Okay, so in this way, this is C, D is concentration of, C stands for concentration and D is the component, that is the product, DRT. So PD is equal to CDRT, PV, PA. So in this way, partial pressure of D, concentration of D into R into T. So in this way, you can write. Now, substituting these values in equation 2. So substituting these values, these values in equation 2. What we get in equation 2? So in terms of partial pressure, we know. So what are the different partial pressure terms? You are going to find out. So if we, what are the partial pressure terms? If we write here, then what happens? Then what we get? Then Kp is equal to C R P whole to the power C, C D R P whole to the power D divided by C A R P whole to the power A and C B R P whole to the power B. So what are the coefficients? If we see this P A P B, so all these values you have substituted and we will get like this. Now rearrange this. So now rearranging this, what we get? We get KP is equal to CCC RP to the power C and CD to the power D RP to the power D divided by CA to the power A RP to the power A and CB B RP to the power B. So in this way you can derive. In this you can find. Or then what we get? So if you arrange all this RP term one side and this CC another side, so what we get? So C, that is CCC and CD to the power D and CA to the power A and CB to the power B, RP whole to the power C plus D minus A plus B. Okay, up to this. And what is this? C, C to the power C, C B to the power B, C, A to the power C, B to the power B. That is equal to KC. This term is equal to KC. In this way, so from equation 1 we get, so KP is equal to this much, or we get KP is equal to KC into RT to the power number of moles of product minus number of moles of the reactant. So number of moles of the product minus number of moles of the reactant, that is your del NG. So KP is equal to KC to the power del NG. Or you can write first your C plus D minus A plus B, and again you can write KP is equal to KC RT whole to the power del NG. So this is the relationship between KP and KC. This is equation 3. Okay. So you can write this. So this is the relationship between KP and KC. Okay. So here we find KP is equal to KC RT to the power del N. Okay. So del N G. Next. When del NG greater than 0, that is positive or positive, or del NG greater than 0, product is more than the reactant. For example, PCl5 gives rise to PCl3 gas plus Cl2 gas. So product means reactant is 1, so del NG greater than 0, then you know KP is equal to KC RT to the power something. So R is the positive factor and T is also a positive term. These two are positive terms and these two into some power to the power some positive term. So in this way, if del N G greater than 0, then this term is positive and multiplied with KC, then it gives you KP. So as these two positive terms is there, so in this way, when del N G greater than 0, then you can find the sum term into a positive term, that means KP is greater than KC. So KP greater than KC. If del N G greater than 0, then KP greater than KC. Next, if del N G is equal to 0, for example, 2HI gas give rise to H2 gas plus I2 gas. I2 gas. So in this case, del N G 0, then KP is equal to KC into R to the power 0. So as R to the power 0, something to the power 0 is equal to 1. In this case, KP is equal to KC. KC. So KP is equal to KC. Okay. Another case, if del N G less than 0 or negative, then what? then Kp is, so Kp is equal to Kc at the power something, or you can say Kc by at p to the power something. So divide Kc by this, so in this way you can write Kp is less than Kc or Kc is greater than Kp. Okay, so in this way this is the relationship between Kc and Kp. So note down this. Next, let us find the relationship between Kp and Kx. So we know that for the gaseous reaction, A of A plus B of B give rise to C of C plus D of D, Kp is equal to, that is, partial pressure of C to the power C, partial pressure of D to the power D, partial pressure of A to the power A, and partial pressure of B to the power B. This is equation 1. And Kx, that is equal to x of Kj, that is mole fraction of C to the power C, mole fraction of D to the power D, by mole fraction of A to the power A, mole fraction of B to the power B. This is equation 2. Okay? So again from ideal gas equation, what we know, PV is equal to NIP, or PIV is equal to NIRP. Equation, suppose this is 3, and this is suppose equation 4. Now, divide equation 4 by equation 3. What we get? PIV by PV is equal to NIRT by NRT. So VV cancels, RT cancels. You can write PI upon P is equal to NI upon N. Okay? What is this? PI is the partial pressure of ice component and P is the total pressure. NI, number of moles of the ice component, and N is known as the total number of moles. Or I can write PI is equal to NI by N into P. Where NI is the number of moles of one component and N is known as total number of moles. And you know, number of moles of one component divided by the total number of moles, that give rise to the mole fraction, and known as J. Okay, that is equal to J of I component into P. Okay, similarly, what we get? P A is J A into P, or mole fraction of A into P. P B is equal to J B into P. PC is equal to JC into P, and PD JD into P, or mole fraction of D. Substituting these values, in equation 1. So what is the partial pressure of all these components? Substituting these values in equation 1, what we get? We get Kp is equal to, that is, Jc P to the power C Jd into P to the power D divided by Ja P to the power Jap to the power A into Jbp to the power B. Okay? So or what we get? Or it is Kp is equal to xi e to the power c xi d to the power d by xi a to the power a xi b to the power b into so p to the power c p to the power c plus d. So all these parts we have rearranged. P to the power c plus d minus a plus b, and this term is not but so this term is known as kx. So from equation 2 we know or kp is equal to kx into p to the power del mg. So kp is equal to kx into p to the power del mg. So give it equation number 5. Okay, give it equation number 5. So this is the relationship between kp and kx. This is the relationship between kp and kx. Next come the relation between kc and kx. So from kp and kc relation we know, from kc and kp relation we know kp is equal to kc at p to the power del ng. So this is equation 1. And again we know kp is equal to kx into p to the power del ng. This is both equation 2. Now what is the relationship between kc and kx? Now dividing equation 1 by equation 2, we get, so this is kp is equal to kc. Okay, now equating, so kc is equal to this one and kp is equal to this one. Now equating equation 1 and 2, we get, you can divide also, and divide also you get kp by kp, that is equal to 1, and this 2 term. So in this way this is equal to this. In dividing, in division also you get what is the same equation, and now equating also you can get the same equation. So we know kp is equal to this much and kp is equal to this much. So now equating equation 1 and 2 we get kc into rp to the power del ng is equal to kx p to the power del ng, or kc by kx, that is p by rt to the power del ng, or kc is equal to kx p by rt to the power del ng. So this is the relationship between kc and kx. Again we can know pv is equal to nrt, or p is equal to nrt by v. If you substitute the value of nrt by v, okay, or you can also get kc is equal to kx nrt by v rt to the power del ng, or kc is equal to kx n by v to the power del ng. So this is also the relationship between kc and kx. Okay, now let us study what are the characteristics of equilibrium constant. First, do understand about this, and after that, I will give you the notes for it. So first, the equilibrium constant does not depend upon the initial concentration of the reactant. It depends on the concentration at equilibrium condition. Okay, so first, independent of initial concentration. So the equilibrium constant is independent of initial concentration. Whatever the concentration for a particular reaction, it should have some fixed value of concentration at equilibrium. In this way, the equilibrium constant depends on the concentration at equilibrium. It is independent of initial concentration of the reactants. Number two, the equilibrium constant is a constant at a particular temperature. With change in temperature, the equilibrium constant changes. So, for a particular reaction, it is constant at a particular temperature. And with change in temperature, it changes. Okay, so the relationship between the equilibrium constant and temperature is given by equation log K2 by K1 is equal to del H by 2.303 R log K2 minus K1, no log. Log K2 by K1 del H by 2.303 R K2 minus K1 by K1 into K2. Okay, so it is constant at a particular temperature. It depends on temperature. The relationship between it. So K2 and K1 are the equilibrium constants at temperature T2 and T1. And del H is known as the enthalpy of a reaction. R is known as the universal gas constant. Look here. If this is an exothermic reaction, then its del H value is negative, and this del H value is negative. So this T2 is greater than T1, so temperature increases, and this del H value is negative, then the whole total term becomes negative, and log K2 by K1 becomes negative. In this way, K2 now becomes less than K1. Okay? So for exothermic reaction, the value of equilibrium constant decreases. And if it is an endothermic reaction, then its del H value is positive, and this value is positive if T2 greater than T1, and all total value is positive, and log K2 by K1, this is also positive. So log K2 by K1 is positive. Log K2 by K1, if this is positive, then log K2 greater than log K1 or K2 greater than K1. In this way, for endothermic reaction, equilibrium constant increases with increase in temperature. For exothermic reaction, equilibrium constant decreases with decrease in temperature. Okay, next. So, the equilibrium constant of a particular reaction is constant at a particular temperature. It changes with change in temperature. Next, when the equilibrium constant of the equation is reversed, then the equilibrium constant value is inversed. Look here. Suppose it is given H2 gas plus I2 gas gave rise to 2HI gas. And suppose the equilibrium constant is K here. If the reaction is reversed, that means when we go from product to reactant, then 2HI gas give rise to H2 gas plus I2 gas. So in this case, the new equilibrium constant K gas, that is equal to 1 by K. So if the reaction is inversed, the equation is inversed, then the new equilibrium constant is inversed. Okay, new equilibrium constant is inversed, the reaction is reversed, then the new equilibrium constant is inversed. Next, if the equilibrium constant with the equation is multiplied by n factor, if the equilibrium constant is multiplied by n factor, then the new equilibrium constant is the nth power of the first one. For example, look here. If 2HI, same equation is here. Suppose this equation is there, that is H2 gas plus I2 gas give rise to 2HI gas, and here the equilibrium constant it is K. Then if the equation is half H2 plus half I2 give rise to HI, so half is multiplied here, then the same equilibrium constant K gas is K to the power half, that means root over of K. And multiplied by n factor, suppose A plus B give rise to product, and NA plus NB give rise to product. Okay, then suppose the equilibrium constant here is K, and in this case the equilibrium constant, new equilibrium constant, be the nth power of that. So if it's multiplied by a number, then the new equilibrium constant is the nth power of the first one. Okay. Next one. So if there are multi-step reactions, there are multi-step reversible reactions are there, and each case there are different equilibrium constant. Suppose A give rise to B, here the equilibrium constant is K1, and B give rise to C, here the equilibrium constant is K2, and C give rise to D, and the equilibrium constant is K3. Then if we go from A to D, so we can A to D, you can directly go by adding this equation. So this is suppose equation 1, and this is equation 2, and this is equation 3. In this way, we can get A to D by adding equation 1 plus equation 2 plus equation 3. So if in a multi-step reaction, if the different types of equilibrium constants are there, then A to D, the new equilibrium constant K dash, that will be the multiplication of K1 into K2 into K3. Okay? Similarly, if we get any equation by subtracting it, then the new equilibrium constant will be get by dividing it. So if we get the equilibrium, the new equation by adding so many number of so many states of equations having the equilibrium constants K1, K2, K3, then the new equilibrium constant is the multiplication of all these. Similarly, if there is any equation we get by subtracting it, then the new equilibrium constant that should be get by dividing it. Okay? So in this way, we can calculate the equilibrium constant. Next, this equilibrium constant is independent of catalyst. So by using catalyst, it does not change the value of equilibrium constant. Independent of initial concentration, independent of catalyst. But it depends on the temperature for a particular reaction. Next, the equilibrium constant also predicts the extent of reaction. The extent of reaction means, you know, that is the K is equal to product by reactant. If this K value is equal to product concentration by reactant concentration. So if K value is larger, that indicates the reaction proceeds more towards product. More amount of products are formed than the reactant. Similarly, larger K value indicates more amount of products are formed, and less value of K represents more amount of reactant is formed. So this reaction is moved towards reactant, or the reaction more amount of reactant is present or more amount of product is formed, that can be known by this equilibrium constants. So these are the characteristics of equilibrium constants. Now you note down these characteristics points. So note down these points. Equilibrium constant is applicable only when the reactant and products have attain the equilibrium. The value of equilibrium constant does not depend upon the initial concentration of the reactant and products, however, it depends upon the molar concentrations in the equilibrium state. The value of equilibrium constant indicates the extent of the reaction. Larger the value, the extent of the reaction is towards product. Smaller the value, the extent of the reaction is towards the reactant. The equilibrium constant is a constant for a particular reaction at a particular temperature. So with change in temperature, the equilibrium constant changes. Equilibrium constant changes with change in temperature. So the relationship between equilibrium constant and temperature is given by the equation this one. So note down first these points. For exothermic reaction, the equilibrium constant value increases with increase in temperature, and for endothermic reaction, it increases with increase in temperature. From that relation, we can find out. So the relation generally log K2 by K1, K2 by K1, then H by 2.303 R T2 minus T1 by T1 into T2. So for exothermic reaction, this value tells us negative, the total term becomes negative, initial log K2 by K1 becomes negative, or log K2 less than log K1, or K2 less than K1. In this way, equilibrium constant decreases with increase in temperature for exothermic reaction. And for endothermic reaction, this tells us value is positive, the total term will become positive. In this way, log K2 by K1 is positive, or log K2 greater than log K1, or K2 greater than K1. In this way, as K2 greater than K1, so in this way, for endothermic reaction, this equilibrium constant increases with increase in temperature. So from this relation, we know. Next one, the value of equilibrium constant does not change by the addition of catalyst. Then for a reversible reaction, the equilibrium constant for the backward reaction is the inverse of the equilibrium constant of forward reaction. Suppose H2 and I2 give rise to 2HI. In this case, the equilibrium constant represented as HI square by H2 into I2. If this is equal to 50, then if the reaction is reversed, 2HI give rise to H2 gas plus I2 gas. So in this case, the KC dash, that is equal to KC prime is equal to H2 and I2 divided by HI. So this is the inverse of this. In this, this is the reciprocal or inverse of this 1 by 50. Okay. Next, some other points are also there. So note down first. Next, the value of K changes with change in stoichiometric coefficient, means if the equilibrium is multiplied by n factor, then the new equilibrium constant is the nth power of old one. So by writing this equilibrium constant expression, you can find out this. For example, in the same question, the same equation, H2 gas plus I2 gas 2HI, the KC value is 49, and if it is multiplied by half, that means the new equilibrium constant is the square root of the first one. Okay, this is the square root of the first one. Then half H2 plus half I2, HI is KC dash is equal to 49, or here KC dash is equal to root over of KC. So just express what is the equilibrium constant, then you can find this relation. In a multi-state equilibrium, if the net equilibrium constant will be the product of net equilibrium constant will be the product of equilibrium constant of individual states. So by adding, if you get any equation, then the new equilibrium constant is the multiplication of all. And the value of equilibrium constant depends upon the unit of value. Actually, these are not value, the unit of equilibrium constant. The unit of equilibrium constant depends upon the units in which the concentration of different species are expressed. However, the unit of Kc is mole liter to the power del ng, and Kp is atmosphere to the power del ng. So note down this. So next come to convention for writing expression for equilibrium constants. So for writing an equilibrium constant, we have known that the equilibrium constant is, this is the product of molar concentration of product species. This is the ratio of product of molar concentration of the product species divided by the product of molar concentration of the reactant species. But this is generally true for homogeneous reaction, homogeneous equilibrium condition. But if there is an heterogeneous system, that is different phases are there, then what happens? Suppose some are solid, some reactants or products are in solid, and some are in liquid state are there, and some are in gaseous state, in different phase are there. Then at that time, the concentrations for pure solid and pure liquid is taken as one. This is first thing. And if in a reaction, if one of the reagent is present large excess, so that its concentration do not change during the reaction, at that time its concentration is also taken as one. So in some cases which is taken large excess, so that its concentration do not change during the reaction, for that the concentration term is taken as one. And another thing, if this is a pure solid or pure liquid, then in that case also the concentration terms are taken as one. Look here, suppose it is given CaCO3 solid gave rise to CaO, when precipitate it gave rise to CaO solid plus CO2 gas. Then in this case, what we can write? Kc is equal to CaO solid, CaO concentration, CO2 concentration divided by CaCO3. But if we consider about solid and this gas, so this gases have larger volume and less mass. So as compared to the volume of calcium carbonate and calcium oxide, in this way the concentration of these solid substances are taken as one. So actually this is one. In this way you can write Kc is equal to only the concentration of CO2. This is only the concentration of CO2, and similarly Kp is power of Kp is the partial pressure of CO2, the pressure of CO2. So in this way, here the unit of Kc is mole and liter inverse, and here the unit of Kp is atmosphere. Mole per liter or mole liter inverse and atmosphere. Okay. Next come to suppose another example. Look here, suppose another equation is given, that is NH4Cl solid, and when it decomposes it gives ammonia solid, sorry, ammonia, this is gas, plus HCl gas. So in this case this is pure solid, so Kc is only, it's NH3, yeah, concentration of NH3 and molar concentration of HCl. So in this case, unit is mole per liter. So its unit is mole per liter square. Okay. And in this case, Kp is partial pressure of ammonia and partial pressure of HCl. So here the unit is, that is atmosphere to the power 2. Okay. Next come to some other examples. For example, if it is given NH3 gas plus H2O liquid give rise to NH4 plus aqua plus OH minus aqua. Suppose in this way it is given. Suppose instead of gas, suppose we take the aqua solution of ammonia, then you can write aqua. But the amount of ammonia, that will give you NH4 plus and OH minus ion. So in this way, here the Kc is, that is NH4 plus aqua, OH minus aqua divided by NH3 aqua. And water is taken at the solvent, it's general solvent, it's taken large excess, its concentration is taken at 1. So in this way, this is the unit. But here the unit is moles per liter, here the unit is moles per liter, and here the unit is moles per liter. So moles per liter cancel, and here the unit is mole per liter. Okay? So there are aqueous form, no Kp is there, in aqueous form you cannot express. Another example, suppose I want to give you 3 Fe solid plus 4 H2O gas give rise to Fe3O4 solid plus 4 H2 gas. So in this case, here the Kc is, actually this is pure solid, these are taken as 1. So Kc is H2 gas to the power 4 by, this is H2O gas condition is given, H2O to the power 4. So H2 to the power 4 by H2O to the power 4, we can express the cases like this. But what is the unit? It's moles per liter to the power, moles per liter to the power 4, moles per liter to the power 4. So in this way, this is unitless. This is unitless. Okay, and in this case, what is the Kp? Kp is also partial pressure of H2 to the power 4 by partial pressure of H2O to the power 4. And Kp, this is also unitless. Okay, so in this way, you can express what is the equilibrium constants. How to express the equilibrium constant? Remember, for pure liquid or pure solid, this is taken as 1, and if the solvent or any medium which is taken in large excess, at that time the concentration of that part is also taken as 1. Another example, here I want to give you CH3CO C2H5, this is ester, reacts with water. Water is taken large excess, this is taken in large excess, so that it remains constant during the reaction, and that gives rise to CH3COH liquid plus C2H5OH liquid. So in this case also, Kc is equal to CH3COH concentration, C2H5OH concentration divided by CH3COC2H5 concentration. Okay, so in this way, moles per liter, which unit is moles per liter, hence the unit is mole per liter. It is mole per liter. So in this way, you can express the equilibrium constants. So look at what are the reactants, what are the products, whether any pure form is given, then you can express. Okay, so for today, up to this.